We're trying to help integrate renewable energy sources in the grid, and that means solar energy and wind energy. And the problem with these resources is they are hard to predict and they vary over time. Demand for electricity will go down middle of the night, go to a minimum around 5 in the morning, then starts ramping up as people get to work, and then it goes down a little bit and then goes back up, and then it goes back down as people go back to bed.
Traditionally, we had a conventional, what's called thermal power plants, coal plants, gas plants, that were able to follow those variations. But those variations were a lot slower and a lot easier to predict than what we're going to have to face with solar generation.
What is happening in California, in Southern California in particular, is that the power generated by solar tends to peak around noon, and it's obviously zero around at night. So the power that needs to be produced from other sources of generation tends to vary, where it goes down around the middle of the day, and then in the evening it starts ramping up very fast as people come home from work, at the same time as the power produced by solar generation decreases, and then it goes back down later at night. The problem is this very rapid ramp, starting around 5 in the afternoon and then around 8 o'clock in the afternoon. This is a big increase that other sources of generation have to compensate for, and it's also a very fast increase, and that creates problem for the operators of the grid. They are not able to follow this demand, the whole system might collapse. This problem is getting serious. It has already created very severe problems in Hawaii, for example, because Hawaii is a series of fairly small power systems where they have had to limit the amount of solar generation that they allow in the grid because it was creating so many problems. So here we are looking at installing batteries in the grid, and the type of research we do aims at figuring out how many batteries should we install, how big should these batteries be, and where are the better locations for these batteries. And these batteries can do two things. On the one hand, they can do what you call arbitrage, which is essentially you charge the batteries when you have a surplus of energy, for example at night if there's a lot of wind, and then you discharge the batteries when you have a deficit of energy, for example in the evening when the sun has gone down and people start using a lot of electricity at home to cook or watch television. You can also use these batteries for doing what we call regulation, taking care of the rapid fluctuations that happen in the grid. For example, if you have a band of cloud going over an area where you have a lot of solar generation, that reduces the amount of energy being produced until the clouds blow over. Well, you can use the batteries to do a rapid discharge to compensate for these reduction in solar production. So far we have done some computer simulation on large systems. What we're hoping to do with this project is to study how installing a battery or a couple batteries on campus might help us test the control algorithm that we have been developing to try to smooth the variations in the solar production on campus, or balance the load on campus with the solar generation.
To find out more about the work that Daniel Kirschen and others are doing, visit the Clean Energy Institute website.